Up, we have another Recycler of the Year award. This one is for the Business Recycler of the Year, honoring businesses showing outstanding efforts and/or leadership in recycling. And the nominees are the Assistance League of Salem Kaiser, a nonprofit serving 30,000 people in the community through 9 programs. A large portion of the Assistance League's funds are raised through resale shops, helping keep useful goods and furniture cycling through the community and out of the garbage. Thousands of pounds of packing material collected during their school supply drives and at their stores is reused, donated, or recycled. They created a purchasing agent to ensure the purchase of greener products, and all of their special events are zero waste. And then we have DIY Studio. Yay! DIY Studio offers a huge array of repurposed material for sale for creative reuse in arts and crafts projects, as well as offering classes to help people get people's creative juices flowing. Their mission is to promote creativity, community, environmental awareness, and self-sufficiency through reuse. And since the May of last year, they've diverted an average of 155 pounds of solid waste for each day they're open. And next we have Life Source Natural Foods. Life Source recycles or reuses 92% of the store's waste. That's amazing. They assign a staff person to daily recycle duty. They used reclaimed beams when they remodeled their storefront. And their sustainability coordinator chooses products that contain less packaging or recycled materials. And then we have Marion County Jail. The jail has recycling bins for metal, wood, plastic, cardboard, batteries, and paper. And in addition, the jail inmates sort through the daily trash to recover anything that missed getting into the bins, as well as to recover cleaning rags, socks, shirts, pants, towels, and even used soap. And if you haven't heard of that program, it's called Clean the World, and they're able to sanitize the soap and send it out to developing places that have issues with sanitary conditions. And actually, the hotel here also participates in that program. Yes. Some of the collected material is sold to local businesses to add income to the Inmate Education Fund, and these efforts have saved tons of trash from entering the waste stream each month. And our final nominee is the Oregon Department of Corrections. A little theme going. In addition to the standard recyclables, the Department of Corrections also recycles non-standard materials, including 5-gallon buckets, textiles, shoes, foam, lead, chip bags, and ballistic vests. Probably something many of you have not had to worry about recycling yourselves, hopefully. They've also diverted 54,000 pounds of fabric from the waste stream just since October of last year, 54,000 pounds. And finally, chip, ramen, and other snack bags are donated to TerraCycle, and proceeds are donated to local charities. And the winner is, and I'm using these creatively reused scraps of fabric that have been turned into fortune cookies to reveal our winners. The Oregon Department of Corrections. Come on up.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around a bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling on down the slant.
The Oregon Department of Corrections started a sorting line for their own recyclables in the summer of last year. And this is an incredible venture where they are operating their own material recovery facility at their central distribution center. So the scope of this is massive, because when the distribution center sends out materials to all the jails in the state, they are bringing back all of the mixed recyclable material to this location in Salem. They bought this sort line, and they're using the inmates to help sort these materials. And if we can go on to the next slide, you get an example of how many different kinds of categories they're looking at sorting. This poster on the left is just fabrics, and so they are sorting into each of the individual types of fabrics. And then on the other poster, we've got displays showing the different types of plastic and paper and some other sorts as well. So they're gleaning an incredible amount of recoverable material from their entire waste stream across the state, but bringing it here to Marion County, where we get to count it in our recovery rate. So we're happy with that. And here we also have them sorting out the chip and ramen bags for TerraCycle, which is a company that pays a per bag fee that was donated to charity in the name of Department of Corrections. And they use it to upcycle, make wonderful things like the dress that Jessica Ramey was wearing for the Trash and Show. And they make backpacks and coin purses and just a whole array of upcycled materials with those bags. And here you can see bales of paper for sale after they've bundled them and it's getting ready to go off to market. And there is that pile of textiles, 27 plus tons so far. And they also are composting a lot of food waste. At least two of their facilities are using earth tubs, which are in-vessel composters. So congratulations, Department of Corrections.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around a bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm